Hello and thanks for joining us. This is the second last weather and climate outlook update for the grain growing regions of New South Wales and Queensland, focusing on rainfall from May to September 2024. We hope we've left a legacy behind. We'd still love to hear from you. So if you've watched our video since February 2023 and have learned something along the way, for example, how to interpret and compare global models, or found the content to be interesting or helpful for your decision making, please get in touch with us. You can do so by emailing agriculture@bom.gov.au. In this update, we'll first look at the 10-day rainfall forecast, followed by the rainfall outlook to September, and then a look back at the April that was. Starting now with the 10-day accumulated rainfall maps, comparing the EC model on the left-hand side with the access model on the right. The main watch point will be a band of rain and storms developing over western New South Wales and southwest Queensland from Thursday the 9th of May, and then pushing east into Friday and over the weekend. This is due to first, very persistent easterly winds pushing moist air onto New South Wales and southern Queensland, and that's combining with an upper level trough moving through from the west. We do see good consistency between the two models, where we're expecting between 20 to 40 millimetres over the next 10 days, but of course, right under storms or heavier showers, we could see heavier totals. The one area of difference we do see is over southern New South Wales, particularly the Riverina. The EC model does push rainfall down into northern Victoria and does include rainfall for places like Wagga, but on the right hand side, the access model is not at this stage indicating any rainfall over southern New South Wales and Wagga's mostly missing out. As we head into the last 2 weeks of May though, we do see a drier signal return to southern New South Wales, and this will likely be due to a blocking high pressure system over the south, preventing some of those cold fronts coming through. But for northern New South Wales, especially north of about Dubbo and into Queensland, we're expecting a typical to wetter than typical end to May, and this is likely due to above average sea surface temperatures, as well as the possibility of continuing to see east coast lows off the east coast. On to June and the chance of exceeding median rainfall in the Access, EC and US models. The real watch point into June will be above average sea surface temperatures continuing off the east coast of Australia. This is really reflected in the US model on the right hand side, where we do see very large areas of green indicating more than 70 to 80% chance of exceeding median rainfall. But what that means for areas to the west of the divide is that anytime we do see these easterly winds coming through, that can actually push moisture onto the coast. And like what we're seeing over the weekend, combined with upper level systems coming through from the west. The EC and the access model don't have this to quite the same extent, but they are all indicating that if we do see these easterly winds come through, we can expect to see median or above median rainfall. Extending the outlook now to the winter months of June to August, and straight away we see that the EC and the US models are currently indicating more than 60 to even more than 70 to 80% chance of exceeding median rainfall for much of Queensland and New South Wales. A real key driver of this is that, as you mentioned in previous updates, many of the global models are currently indicating that La Niña thresholds will be met through the winter months. And of course, this does mean that we will see more of these easterly winds coming onto the coast, pushing that warm sea surface and a lot of moisture onto New South Wales and Queensland. The access model doesn't quite have it to the same extent, but looking at the EC and the US models, it is giving us some confidence in this consistency between these two global models. So while the access model is a little bit of an outlier at this stage, we can still look at how the rainfall probabilities are distributed, comparing Emerald and Tamworth. At Emerald, we do see about a 40 to 45% chance of exceeding median rainfall from June to August. Looking at the distribution below, we see that it is fairly flat, but weighted towards some of those dry deciles. In Tamworth, we see about a 50% chance of exceeding median rainfall and a flatter distribution, but a little bit of a bias towards the middle bar here. If we extend the outlook now all the way to September, we do see that the access has now come into line with EC and the American models, and all three models do indicate above a 60% chance of exceeding median rainfall over those 3 months. What we do know is that if you do head into La Niña has the strongest influence on rainfall across eastern Australia over the winter and spring period, and this is very much being reflected across the three maps. And another watch point would be just how much moisture does move down from WA across central Australia and into inland parts of New South Wales and southern Queensland. But at this stage, we are seeing consistency across the three models, and so that does give us confidence in that we are expecting to see above median rainfall for these 3 months. Finally, a look back at the April that was, and this is looking at the rainfall deciles for the month. The warm sea surface temperatures off the coast of Australia played a very large part in April rainfall in pushing a lot of moisture onto the coast, and that's reflected in some high rainfall totals. We saw more than 100 millimetres at both Dubbo and Tamworth, and even up into southeast Queensland for places like Dalby, we saw more than 100 millimetres, but further west, rainfall totals were a little bit more hit and miss. Southern New South Wales actually missed out, with really only between 10 to 30 millimetres falling south of Hay. That's it for this Grains Climate Outlook. As you've heard, this will be the second last video that we do. But please do send your feedback and comments to agriculture@bom.gov.au. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.